Kepler's third law, also known as law of time. The square of its period of revolution around the sun is directly proportional to the cube of the mean distance of a planet from the sun. That is, if r is the average distance of the planet from the sun and t is its time period of revolution, then t square is directly proportional to r cube, or t square by r cube is equal to constant. This is what Kepler said. Now let's take the example of Earth and Mercury to understand this. Here I have taken two examples, that is Earth and Mercury. We know that the time period taken by Earth to complete one revolution is 365 days. So T1 is equal to 365 days, and Mercury takes 88 Earth days to complete its revolution. That is, T2 is equal to 88 Earth days. The average distance of Earth and Sun is 150 million kilometers. So R1 is equal to 150 million kilometers, whereas Mercury is 58 kilometers far. So R2 is taken as 58 million kilometers. So Kepler said that T square is directly proportional to R cube. Here we'll take this T1 square upon T2 square is equivalent to R1 cube upon R2 cube. T1 square upon R1 cube is equivalent to 1332225 upon 337500, which is equivalent to 0.039. When we divide T1 square by R1 cube, that is, when we find the square of 365 and find the cube of 150, we get this values, and when we divide this, we are getting this value. So this is of Earth. Let's see with the Mercury. So when Mercury we are taking, T2 square by R2 cube. So which is 7744 divided by 195112. And the value which we get after division is 0.039. So what Kepler said is correct. That is, T square upon R cube is a constant which is denoted by K.